Hey everyone, it's Lindsay from My Crafty Plans. I'm so excited. So today I am finally flipping through my 2020 memory planner, which is 100% done now. If you have been with this channel for a little while, you know I had to take like a 3-month hiatus from filming and planning when we moved because our construction wasn't finished, so my stuff wasn't set up. Anyway, I did catch up on all of my spreads, and now I thought it would be super fun to revisit my entire 2020 planner before I put it away into my storage. This is, of course, an R Estelle A5 wide cloud planner. It is in the, I forget what this color is called. I do have a full setup for this. It had silver hardware. It's like that light bluish color that was in the first cloud release. I was so excited when these came out. Before this came out, and actually if you go back and watch my full 2020 plan with me playlist, which I will link in the description and up in the cards as well, and it's fully updated with all of the spreads in order now, which I just did so that I could have all of the names of the kits for you. But anyway, if you go back to the beginning of that, in the beginning of the year, I was in an Erin Condren binder. And then when these cloud planners came out, I went ahead and picked one up and repunched my Erin Condren inserts and used those in here. And now I'm still in a cloud planner for 2021, obviously, but using specific inserts for that. I apologize about my finger. I have a really, really bad cut on my finger. And then I just decided to be festive and put a little bit of washi around my Band-Aid. I don't know if that makes it better or worse. Anyway, I do also have a full setup for this planner, which I will go ahead and link as well. Sorry if you can see my computer a little bit there. I have it showing so that I can see it, so that I know all of the kit names. I'm not going to show monthly spreads. I only did the monthlies. Well, I'll just show that. But like, I'll quickly flip through them. I don't remember what I used. This is, I believe, from Sadie Stickers. I only did it for January, February, and March. And then after that, after the baby was born, I kind of gave up. And I'm hoping to do that this year in my planner, but we'll have to see. But anyway, so this is my first spread of 2020, which feels like 6 million years ago in terms of like everything that's happened in the past year and a half or so. This feels like so long ago. Like on a personal level, we had one less child at this point. We lived in a different house. It was like a completely different world. No one had ever heard of like, so I didn't know what social distancing was. Anyway, completely different world on a personal and world level. But it is fun to like go back and look at this and see everything that went back. And so this was my first spread of the year, and this kit was called Party, and it was from Sadie Stickers, and I used some silver foil as well. And then this is some Scribble Prints Co. washi, and then mostly my washi is from Simply Gilded, obviously, but super, super cute there. Then next up, I have an October mystery kit from Scribble Prints Co. I actually have two October mystery kits from two separate years fairly close together in here, and they both just say October mystery. So I actually think that this one was from 2019. No, I think this was from 2019, and the last one was from 2018. I don't know. I didn't write down what years they were, but this was at some point a October mystery kit, also with silver foil. I always use a lot of silver foil in the winter, and this was like kind of like a very chill, cozy reading vibes. I use so many reading kits this year. I also do, at the end, I'm gonna run through a tally of like all the different the foils that I've got so far. That's 2 for silver, 3 for silver. We are starting in winter after all. Then this kit was called Keep Warm, and it was from Artbox Stickers, who's unfortunately not open anymore, but this really cute snowy vibes. At this point, I was very, very pregnant. We were just beginning to think about like house shopping. Oh no, we were house shopping, because this was when we actually had our house offer accepted. We didn't end up moving until October because we had some COVID complications and then construction and all this stuff. But anyway, and then we also packed up and we took the kids to the Poconos this weekend, to the Kalahari water park resort, which is like a terrifying thought right now given the universe. But at that point, it was really fun, and it was like a little, I won't call it a baby moon because we took two kids, but it was like a baby moon for the fam and the toddlers, and that was really fun. So that was a really fun week. Other than that, I don't know, like nothing else going on these other weeks. And then this is also a Scribble Prints Co. October mystery kit. This one I think is from the year before, and I had like saved it Because I feel very strongly, though it's not confirmed, that the art in this is actually inspired by the city of Philadelphia, and we live in the Philadelphia area. And when I got this, I'm pretty sure we still lived in Texas, but Philly is like my hometown, so I was really, really excited for it. This just really looks like the Philadelphia skyline, and there is like a place you can go ice skating, like that's right downtown where you can kind of see the skyline at Penn's Landing in Philly. So I just really thought that this kit looked a lot like Philadelphia. I saved the journaling card that came with this, like all the stuff, because to me this is a very Philly kit. So anyway, I was really excited about that. And then in February, I did actually just use a Simply Gilded kit. I like periodically try and use these to do non-planner things, because I won't use them on a weekly spread. I don't find them like functional, but I thought that came out pretty cool. I did not plan the monthly. I don't have videos for the monthly spreads, but I do have videos for all of these weekly spreads. And then this is a kit called Shine Bright from Inky and the Brain. And this is a rose gold foil, my first rose gold of the year. Super, super cute here. And then next up, we have this adorable kit called Slumber Party from Sticky Essentials. I absolutely love this. This is like so cute. I don't really remember if, I don't remember why I used this kit this week. I don't think there was like anything specific Slumber Party-y. Like, yeah, because my daughter like just recently had her first sleepover at a grandparent's house. So I don't think that there was anything. It does look like my daughter had a really big weekend this weekend, because she went to see a Nick Jr. live and to see Frozen 2 in the movies with each grandparent. But yeah, this was just the kit that I used this week, and I do think it's like really, really cute. And then this is Forever, I think, by Scribble Prints Co. It was the week of Valentine's Day kit, and now we are going to transition into some baby kits, because this was actually the last full week that I was pregnant. I can remember I was trying to time this out I was really trying very hard to time this out. Obviously, you don't know exactly when your baby's gonna be born, but this was my third baby. I feel like I had a better little bit of an idea, and this was the last full week that I was pregnant, and I wanted this kit to be used on the last full week that I was pregnant, but I wanted to use it before I had the baby for sure. So since it has like the maternity girl on it, so I did go ahead and use it this week. My due date was March 1st, and this was the week of February 17th. All of my kids came before their due date, but each of them came later than the last. So my first baby was born at 38 weeks, my second baby was born at 39 weeks, and my last baby was born at like 39 and a half weeks. So just a weird thing that happened. I don't really know. Anyway, this was the last time I did a monthly spread, and this is from Scribble Prints Co. and it was like old birthday theme art, but we have a lot of birthdays in March, plus I was like, you know, the baby and everything. So yeah, so that is the last kit. Oh, and that Crafts by Tally kit was called Oh Baby. And then next up, we have the actual week that the baby was born. This kit, I planned this after the baby was born. It's got like a ton of journaling space in there where I just like wrote my whole birth story, everything that happened, all that good stuff. It was really fun, and I used day extenders to do that. But this is, this kit is called Baby Mine from Scribble Prints Co. And I played all of these after the week happened, obviously, but so I already knew that the baby was born when I did this. But yeah, so anyway, I had been specially saving this kit for that. And then the week after that was actually my oldest daughter's birthdays. Their birthdays are like 4 or 5 days apart, so depending on the year and whether or not there's a leap day. So I did have that right back to back, and then we'll get back to baby kits. So this was called Princess Party, and it is also from Scribble Prints Co. So I do have two Scribble Prints Co. kits back to back there. Then next up, we've got this kit, which is like a very neutral, pretty baby kit from Sticky Essentials, and this one is called Little One. I also like love this. I thought it was so, so cute. And then we have some spring kits. So this is from Planning World. Planning World does kits don't have names. They only have numbers, and I did not write down all of the numbers, so I'm just gonna say it's from Planning World. And I have a few more Planning World spreads in here as well, because I do really like her shop, but I did not get the numbers for any of the kits. But yeah, so this is from Planning World, and it is a foiled kit, and it's just really pretty and like early spring vibes. And then we have a wild one from Scribble Prints Co. So this was my son's birthday, and This is actually the second year in a row. So he turned two this year, and this was the second year in a row that I used this kit. I did use a different kit this year for his third birthday because I finally found another one that I like, but I absolutely love. This is like gotta be one of my all-time favorite Scribble Prince Co. kits. I just love, love, love this. And she designed this, I think, for her first, like her oldest son's first birthday. So yeah, that is that. And then I can just skip all of the monthly pages from now on because I didn't use them. But anyway, then this, we have the like first week in April, and this kit is called Swish and Flick, and it's from Wild Summers Designs. Then next after that was my birthday, and this is a January mystery kit from Scribble Prince Co. It's like this really cute pink planner girl type kit. I really, really like this one. This was a great birthday kit, actually. And then after that, I have this kit called Reading Dreams, and this is from Simply a Mess. I think this is so cute. And then after that, I have two book kits right back in a row. This one's called Novel by Harriet Wright Designs. I absolutely love this. I think it's so, so gorgeous. Love getting to use floral Simply Gilded Washi. And then after that, it is May, or like the last week in April, early week in May. And this is actually when we finally closed on that house. So we had our offer accepted all the way back in January, but because of like COVID stuff and other things that had to happen related to the house that were significantly delayed by COVID, we actually didn't make settlement until April 30th, which for us was really convenient because we ended up saving a lot of like having to pay like rent and mortgage at the same time, because either way we weren't going to be able to start construction until the summer, which we knew at this point, so we were trying to like wait as long as possible to have to pay both on the house, but we still wanted to get the house, obviously. So that's really cute. And I actually used this kit in 2019 as well. This is an old Crest Press mystery kit, and I used this in 2019 as well when we moved back to Philly. And then after that, I have Mama Bear from Two Little Bees. This is the kit I used for Mother's Day this year. Totally different vibes than the kit that I used this year for Mother's Day, which I just planned very recently. And then after that, we have this Spring Bloom kit, which is from, was at the time Sticker Bloom, but that's now Vanilla Paper Co. So that's just this really pretty floral kit. And then up next, I have this Pink Lemonade kit from Sticky Essentials. This also one of my favorite kits of the year. I absolutely love this. I just think it was so pretty. The yellow is so vibrant. I absolutely love yellow, and it's really hard to use yellow in a kit and like everything, but I just thought this looked so, so nice. Then next up, I have this June mystery kit from Scribble Prince Co. So this was like this picnic themed one. Super, super cute as well. And then we are into June, and I have this Be Happy kit from Simply Watercolor Co. This was like a Simply Foiled Tuesday where you can get like this, the two page kit for $10, and then it has like a third page you can add on for $2 or something like that. I haven't done this in a while, but I do think this is really, really cute with the little bees. It is gold foiled, and then you have to bring in a lot of your own functional stuff because it is a pretty small kit. But yeah, then next up after that, I have this Sunny Days kit from Hello Petite Paper. Love this, so, so cute. I don't think we were at the beach yet at this point. I don't think we were at the beach yet at this point, so I'm using like these early summer kits. And then I have this, which was called Mom Life, and it was Sticky Essentials, and this was like the last baby kit I had bought, although this one's just like more generally Mom Life one. And I wanted to use this one this week because I think this is like right before we started going down to the beach for the summer, and then I had like beach kits for the whole rest of the summer, and I was like, if I don't use this now, I'm not gonna use this while I still have like a little baby, because it had like the little stroller and stuff. And I just remember at the time that was very important to me, that I use this kit like before the baby was walking. I don't remember why I was thinking that, and she was only a couple months old at this point, but I figured if I didn't use it now, I wouldn't use it until like next spring. I don't know. And it had like all the baby books and stuff. I wanted to use it when she was a baby. But anyway, so I used it this week, and I actually think that this was the week between when school ended. Or no, this was the last week of, not when school ended. School was not a thing anymore, because like 2 weeks after the baby was born, like the whole world shut down. But this was the last week before camp started. Only my oldest went to camp last summer, but this was like the last week that I had all three kids home together. Yeah, I can see my daughter had like her meet the class Zoom, because so no one had been in school since mid-March. And then this was the last week before my oldest daughter went back to camp. And also, my niece was born this week, so that's fun. I'm just looking at that now. Anyway, next up we have this kit called Summer, also from what is now Vanilla Paper Go, with the washi that I'm featuring on my finger, or a very similar one. It's like my favorite is the tie-dye washi from Simply Gilded. It's like honestly one of my favorite washis ever. I think this is so gorgeous. I absolutely love this kit. Just like looking at this, I would totally buy this again. Yeah, and then we are on into July, and here it is, the 4th of July kit, which is just called 4th, and it's from Sadie Stickers. I think this is so cute, and it's got like a shattered hollow foil on it. And then here is the Safari kit from Paper Muse Crafts. Again, super, super cute. Like, not my usual aesthetic, but I do think that this is really pretty. And then we have this, which I love. This is from Panda Bird Designs, and I just was so obsessed with the colors in this kit. It's so vibrant and so gorgeous. So really, really just, I love this. Anyway, this kit is so pretty. And then this is Ocean Air from Two Little Bees. And at this point, we were definitely going to the beach like pretty much every weekend. My parents bought a new beach house last year as well. And so we weren't going a lot in the beginning of the summer because they hadn't made settlement on this new house yet. And then they did kind of, I think, in mid-July. And then after that, we just started going every weekend. It was so nice, and it's just been really nice. We've been going a lot during the year as well. My mom is actually living there full time because she got rid of her place in the city. So yeah, it's just been really, really nice to have that beach space, and we will definitely be going. I mean, we go to the beach every summer. This was just a new house for this year in like our regular town that we've been going to since I was a little kid. But anyway, after that we have this kit from, this is from Planning World, I think. Oh, nope, I missed it. I was like, I think I'm out of order here. Okay, so then this is called Sail Away. It's from Gilded Press. I think this is so pretty. The vibes on this are really, really pretty as well. Again, it's not like my usual aesthetic, but I just thought this was so gorgeous for a beach kit. Another one of my favorite kits from this year is like very watercolors, just really, really nice. And this is, I can see we're in week 6 of camp here. And then next up, I have this kit from Planning World, which I actually think I got this in either like it was like a ready to ship sale or like a random pull bag, but I thought this was really, really cute as well. This like art, it's like an older art set, but I just thought this was so, so cute. And then here we have a kit from Sadie Stickers. This one is called Summer, very beachy vibes, super like pastel-y, very nice. I feel like I'm saying cute all of the time. Got to use my mermaid washi. And then this was Moon Beach from Vanilla Paper Co. as well. And when I saw this kit with just like the sunset, I just thought this was so stunning. And I looked at, I think, like 17 different shops that were making this kit before I picked which one I wanted, because I had already bought so many beach kits by the time that this art came out, and I didn't want to spend a ton. And Vanilla Paper Co., if you don't know, is a shop with a lower price point, but her shipping takes forever. I do love her stickers, but her shipping takes forever. And anyway, so I did end up picking this up there, and I just absolutely love this. It looks so, so nice. Looking back on this is really nice, and you can see my pages accidentally folded down a little bit there. Oops, okay. Then this was a kit called Serena and Lily from Crest Press, and this was also a mystery kit, and I actually did a collab plan with me with Viv Loves to Plan on this week, which was really fun, and we did like a whole summer plan with me questions thing. And then these were actually 3 weeks off between school and camp, so this one we were down the shore the whole week this week, and my husband was off work, and then we went home for a little bit so that my husband could work, and we just hung out and all of that stuff. And then we went back down the shore, and my husband was off the following week as well, which I used this kit called I Do from Scribble Prince Go, because this was, one, our last week at the beach of the summer. This was the weekend, like this was Labor Day weekend. And then also the first is my husband and my anniversary. This was our 7th anniversary, which I'm glad I wrote that on there, because there's no way I would have remembered that off the top of my head. So just saying. Anyway, this was a really pretty kit. As soon as she came out with this, which was like in the spring, I was like, I need this. That's so perfect, because I always have this like mental debate about whether to use a beach kit this week or whether to use a anniversary like love themed kit, since we're almost always at the beach for this full week. We almost, like my husband almost always takes this off from work, like unless he can't, and then we're almost always at the beach this week. So yeah, That is absolutely perfect. Plus, it's like the end of summer. And then the week after that, I have another Scribble Princeco kit, which was called Hello Class, and it was this back to school kit. This was super exciting because my son had not been in any kind of like school or daycare or anything since March of the year before. He had a really rough transition back, but you know, he is sort of liking it now. I don't know. My oldest would like live at school if you let her, and my son would like never go if you let him. So we'll see what happens with the baby, because she's starting next year too in the toddler room. But anyway, this was the kit that I picked, and I just absolutely love this. It had like very preschool vibes to me. It had like a kid box, so I just really absolutely love this. Then next up, I have another kit from Planning World. I don't know what this is called, and this was the week of Rosh Hashanah, and just really good fall vibes. All into the fall kits yet, but here I have not moved yet, so we're still in the point where I was like, you know, putting these up like the week after they happened or 2 weeks after they happened, etc. And then this one was called Autumn Leaves from Sadie Stickers with all this like gorgeous leopard print. I thought this was so, so pretty. The foiling on her kits is so amazing. And I absolutely love, love, love this. And then we are into October, and we have this kit, which was called Here for Fall from Hello Petite Paper, from Caress Press. So cute. I love this. This is not a mystery kit. Since I get her mystery kit, I don't buy a ton of kits from her shop regularly. This was like so cute that I absolutely could not resist it. I just absolutely love this, and I think it's really cute. Again, I think this is probably one of my favorite spreads of the year as well. The colors on this are just so vibrant. You've got all that gorgeous rose gold foil as well. And then the week after that, I used another Caress Press kit. This was called Here for Fall. This was a mystery kit, and I used the foil that came with this, which is like a more coppery foil, because I did have some Simply Gilded foil that matched this, so I decided to try it out. It's not my favorite, but I do really like it, and it's really pretty, and it came with like enough foil that I feel like it matches my other spreads, even though it's like a little bit of a more unusual foil color for me. Anyway, this is called Sweater Weather. Yeah, so this is called Sweater Weather. It's from Mary Me Bell. I think this is really pretty. This is a foiled kit as well, and I just like love this fashion girl with like the thing over her eye. So I thought this was super, super cute. I loved all the fall kits that I got this year. So much fall goodness, and I just planned some of them, so they are pretty fresh in my mind. Although at this point we hadn't moved yet, so I am still in the sort of like back half of 2020, where I was like planning things as they happen. And then this is actually the last week of that. And this was this homebound kit from Two Little Bees. And this is the week before we moved. And I was doing like most of the packing then, trying to get my stuff together. I was working on a ton of projects at this time too for work. So things were so, so crazy and hectic. This was our worst move ever. Like, to be honest, I've said that before. It was our most disorganized move, I think, because all of our previous moves have been like out of state or distance moves. Like we moved from, well, I guess like going back, we moved from like PA to New York City, from New York City to New Jersey. This is like going back way before we have kids, obviously. Then from New Jersey, we moved up to Boston when my husband was in grad school. And then we went Boston to Austin, Texas, back to Boston, and then back to Austin, Texas. We had like some shuffling back and forth with school. So a lot of like, and then that was all before we had kids. And then the last one, we had a baby at that point in Austin. And then since then, we had just lived in Austin before we moved back to Philly. And that was all of those moves were like super, super organized. And then this move, we were like literally moving 10 minutes away from our rental house to the house that we bought. And it was pure chaos. I don't know if I just thought like, we can be relaxed about this. I just didn't feel like doing it. I had 3 kids. You know, the baby was like still, the baby's home with me all the time. And I just, this move was like a really rough move. But anyway, this was my last spread that I posted in 2020, actually, I think. And then I might have had some videos that I had pre-recorded, but this was like one of my last videos before my few month hiatus. So then this was my first spread back after my hiatus. So planning this kind of like way after it happened, but that's totally fine. I took really good notes so that I could bring all of these spreads to you and also finish them for my own satisfaction as well. And then this kit was called Witch's Brew, and it was from Miriam Bell. We moved during the week of Halloween, but I used the sort of home moving kit. I'm calling this a moving kit. It's not. It was like a homebound kit, but it had like all of the cleaning and organizing stuff. So I used it as a moving kit, but I saved the Halloween kit for this week. And then the week after that, I used this apple orchard kit from Two Little Bees. Super, super cute. And then after this, we have Scarlet from Paper Muse Crafts, another one where as soon as I saw this kit, I fell in love with this kit and I absolutely had to have it. It just, like, the full boxes on this are so, so stunning. And then next up we have Autumn Nights from Scribble Prints Co. I absolutely love this. This is another one where I'm going to say this is one of my favorite spreads of the year. Just really, really gorgeous. Love the rose gold. Then we have Be Thankful from Vanilla Paper Co. This was the week of Thanksgiving. Super, super cute there. And then we are into December and just a few kits left. My last fall kit, which was this fall farmhouse from Sadie Stickers. Really, really cute. Brought in some fun red elements to punch it up a little bit. And then we have this kit from Sticky Essentials, which was the Zen kit. Another at-home, very cozy winter vibes, in my opinion, for this. So I thought that was really cool. And this was the beginning of Hanukkah. And then I have my final two spreads. This Toasted Marshmallow from Two Little Bees. Super, super cute. This went up by, like, this spread went up just like a couple weeks ago. And my last one, also from Two Little Bees, was this Jolly. And this was the week of Christmas. I've mentioned this several times, but I actually just taped the last two pages of the planner together because I planned the week of New Year's Eve in my 2021 planner. So this was the last week of the year, the last week I hadn't planned yet. At this point, I was already caught up in my 2021 planner. And, you know, I've been planning regularly. This video just went up a couple weeks ago. But yeah, so that is all of my 2020 spreads. I just think this was so, so fun. So here is a quick rundown. Okay, just to wrap this up, because I am a total data nerd, I have quickly compiled some stats for my planner. So of the 52 weeks that I planned this year, there are actually 52 weeks since it started with the week of New Year's Eve and ended with the week before New Year's Eve, which was Christmas. For all of 2020, I used 27 foiled kits and 25 unfoiled kits. My most used shop was Scribble Prints Co. with 11 kits, and my next most was Two Little Bees with 6, and then after that, Sadie Stickers and Sticky Essentials, each with 5, and then Caress Press and Vanilla Paper Co., each with 4, and then Planning World with 3, Miriam Bell with 2, and then a bunch of single-use kits, like one kit per shop after that. But so I just have my tops here. I do think that will be very different for next year. I was still getting the Scribble Prints Co. mystery kit for most of this year. So I do think that my next year's planner will be more heavily weighted towards Caress Press. And also some of my shopping habits have changed, but did think that was really interesting. More Two Little Bees than I was expecting, because although I do think a lot of it was towards the end of the year, and that will definitely be on the uptick next year. I have been shopping from her a lot. Anyway, I did use 27 weeks of gold, 12 of silver, 12 of rose gold, and 1 of an alternative foil. So I was right, and I have been saying that I was going to count. I was right. Gold is definitely my most used foil color in here, so I do not feel bad when I only buy something in gold versus the rest of the year. The thing is I feel like gold is good for all year round, matches all seasons. I tend to use a lot more silver in like spring and winter, and I tend to use more rose gold. I tend to use a lot more rose gold in the fall and some in the spring, and I tend to use a lot more silver in winter and I guess a little bit in spring and in some in summer too. So I guess it's almost all year round. I don't know. Anyway, I do definitely use the most gold. In terms of like themes for kits, I bought 12 what I'm calling occasion kits, which is like a birthday or a holiday, whatever. So I have 12 of those. I used 10 summer kits, 4 spring kits, 6 winter, and 9 fall, 4 baby kits, and then 7 anytime kits. So I always buy a ton of summer kits and use a ton of summer kits. Springs, I tend not to use as many spring kits because we have a lot of birthdays in the spring and I had a baby in the spring. So this year it will definitely be more, although there's still a lot of weeks interrupted by birthdays there. But that is just some fun stats for you. What do you use the most in your planner? Let me know. I hope you enjoyed this video. I thought it was really fun to look back on this. And yeah, that is everything. So if you did like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. I'd love it if you'd subscribe and check me out on Instagram to keep up with everything going on my planners. Bye!